Of love that brought me gently. your wisdom we're seeking for. Because, Lord, in the best of us, you can find the worst of us. And so we come and we humble ourselves. Remove all that is unlike you. We're not here for a show. We're not here to be entertained or to entertain anyone. We come because we recognize the seriousness of the time, the urgency of the call, and the danger we are in. We come because tomorrow is not promised to us, and that which we have to get right, we need to do it right now. So Lord, our desire is to be like you, is to hear a word from you. So disappoint us not, but send the power of the Holy Spirit among your people today. For Christ's sake we pray. After 10 days, you're still not talking. I'll go again. Happy Sabbath, everyone. God is good. All those who are blessed, just lift your hands and somebody say, praise the Lord. You appreciate the blessing of the Lord. Let me hear you say, hallelujah. And you desire for the Lord to do something for you. Let me hear you say, amen. Amen. I must say to you that Christianity, whether you believe it or not, or it is news to you, Christianity is the only religion that is led by a living leader. You didn't get that? You want me to repeat it again? Every other religion is led by a dead leader. Check them out. Check them out. I didn't make it up last night. It is reality. Muhammad is dead. Still dead. Buddha, where is he? He's dead. Where is Hare Krishna? Where is he? Where is Selassie? He's dead. But the God of the Christian movement is alive. Irrespective of how dark your situation is, God is willing and able to make something good of you. Amen. I want to welcome all of our visitors today, all those who are visiting with us. You're not a member of this Seventh-day Adventist Church. I'm not going to ask you this time, but just wave your hand wherever you want. All of our visitors, you're not a member. And don't be shy, just put them high and wave them for the Lord. Amen? Amen. Now, I am hoping that before too long, you will be waving them, not just as visitors, but as members of God's remnant church. And all day, my would have come from different churches. We welcome you, whether you're from Hold Road. I see persons from Kitsentown, and I see people from all over. We welcome my sister. don't remember the name, but she ministered to us in song, and we give the Lord the glory. Say amen, church.
Amen.
Amen. Now, this afternoon, we have been praying for 10 days. I hope you were. I was. And I'm still praying. Later on in the afternoon, we're going to be sharing some experience. The elders of the church will have some time, Sister Brown, to lead the church this final day. This was not in the Newton lecture series. This initiative, if at the end of it, we're still where we were, then all we would have done was to waste our time. But at least we must be there closer to Jesus Christ. So later on, we're going to have some testimony, and the elders will lead the church into some focused prayer. We're happy to know that the waters will be troubled. Uh-oh. We still do transfer of membership. So the brethren are not saying amen, my sister. So after you're baptized, I will talk with Pastor and I just take your membership to my church. Amen. Now we go to the word. Reformed and revived. Reformed and revived. Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Everybody, bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. One more time, with some passion and with some purpose. We ask you will not visit us today in your wrath, but you will visit us in your mercy. You will visit Diamond Acres in all your glory. You will turn up, because we know when you turn up to take over. This is your moment. There are sinners in need of saving grace. I can't help them. I can only speak on your behalf. So that which is said, let it be seasoned with grace. That which will be said, let it be anointed by the Holy Spirit. That which will be said, let it be approved of you, sent from you, commissioned by you, and led by you. If anything will be said that you're not pleasing us, remove it, Lord. Because at the end of our sitting, there's only one thing I want to do, and that is to glorify you. That's my purpose today. And for Israel, including myself, to be closer drawn to thee. For Christ's sake, we pray. Amen. Turn your Bibles with me to the book of 2 Kings. 1 Kings chapter 12, rather. 1 Kings, the chapter is 12. We're going to be looking together from verse 25 onwards. What book did I say? 1 Kings, and the chapter is? And we start at verse 25. Amen. You have your Bibles? Amen. Are you here? Let's look at verse 25, everybody. Then, are you there? Are you there? Well, those of us who are not there yet, I pray you will catch us before the day is over. Those of us who are ready, let's go. We start at verse 25, everybody together. Then Jeroboam built. You're not there. I said everybody together. So let's go after two. One, two. Then, build in Mount and dwell therein. And went out from thence and built. Verse 26, Jeroboam said in his heart. Verse 27, if this people go up to what? In the house of the Lord at Jerusalem. And go again to who? King of Judah. Verse 28. The king took counsel and made two calves of gold and said, it is too much for you to go up to Jerusalem. Behold, thy gods, O Israel, which brought thee out of the what? He set the one in Bethel, and the other he put where? And this thing become a sin, for the people went to worship before the one, even unto them. Verse 31, and he made an house of what? And made priests of the what? Lowest of the people, which were none of the sons of Levite. Verse 22, and Jeroboam ordained a what? In the 8th month and in the what? Like unto the what? That is in, and he offered up on the altar, so that he did where? Sacrifice unto the calves that he had made, and he placed in Bethel, which he had what? Verse 33. So he offered, which he had what made in Bethel, the 50
in the month which he had what? Of his own heart. And are dead of what? Unto the children of, and offered upon the altar and burned incense. Now, when you look at the verses before, the people of God asked the king to loosen their burden. Make their burden what? Lighter. But the king took counsel from men in his age group, or men who were much younger than him, and they said to him, if Solomon whipped them with a stick, you must do it with a what? With a scorpion. Make their yoke much heavier. Israel rebelled. Because when you put people under oppression, people will react. Nobody wants to be pressured. And here comes the fear in the king that he might lose his popularity. And instead of going to God and humble himself, he purposed in his heart to lead the people of God further into sin. Look what he did. He said, and we're hearing that today. To read the Bible is too much. To maintain your Christian integrity is too much. To come to church for Sabbath school and stay for Vesper is too much. To be at Sunday night meeting is too much. To come to Wednesday night meeting is too much. So we're going to give you a short cut. I must say to you today, there's only one way we can reach to Jesus Christ. It doesn't matter what we do. If God is not approved of it, then we are in serious problem. It's too much to go up to Jerusalem. Don't worry yourself about that. Don't worry. You don't have to be a strict Christian. As long as you are And he checked the history of the prophet. Most of them, Israel never liked them. Most of them, Israel never want to hear about them. Most of them, Israel slaughtered them. Israel turned their back on them. But they have a word for Israel. There is a word for Diamond Acre. There is a word for this church.
God of a prophet. I don't know if you have studied him and know his name, but I don't see the name registered here from him. In chapter 30, verse 1 of the Bible says, and there came a man of God. And I like the expression. There came a man of God out of where? Judah. By the word of the Lord unto Bethel and Jeroboam, stood up by the altar to burn incense. But the Bible said, there came a man of God. And if he is the man of God, he is at God's business. He have a word from God to God's people. Am I talking to you today? And the Bible said he cried against the altar. He did not address the king. He said nothing to the king. He cried against the altar. Are you reading it? Chapter 13.
And there must be some reverence in Sometimes the preacher's preaching up there. To be honest with you, if he continued to look in the congregation, he might lose his way like David. It's not that you want to be looking at the clock. But to be honest with you, some of the way our sisters dress, I know you would be silent. Because you're telling me this is modern days. And what's wrong? You gotta be in the style.
Straight at me, he was
to go to the Middle East. And so the sun was beating down on him, and he saw a huge boulder in the desert. And he went there to get some shade from the sun. And right around the boulder, he saw a crust of salt. And in frustration, he was kicking at it. And a little piece broke off. And he picked it up. And he put a little piece in his mouth. And he observed that that crust of salt that was staying around the rock still tastes salty. Still maintained its inner. It was still strong. And he concluded that Christian that stayed close to Christ will not lose his character. The Christian that stayed close to Christ will not lose his identity. The Christian that stayed close to Christ will not become irrelevant.
May not be popular, but you will trust in Jesus.
Am I talking with you? And this is not about being famous. This is not about people running after you and picking you up. This is about people following and glorifying the name of Jesus Christ. The spotlight should never be on you. The spotlight must always be on the cross, because it is at the cross, where we first saw the what? And the burden of our heart. It was there by faith.
Said when the king put forth his hand to touch the prophet of God, and this is something we must understand. This way, you decide to have a step up for Jesus, no matter who come against you, if God said, they can't touch you. Am I talking with you? Am I talking to the believer? The believer have a protection nobody else have. You need to get that. You know what David tell me? He said, they not trust in the Lord, not you.
And medical professionals said it appeared as if it was gangrene. And nobody could help him. You see, when God puts something by you, only God can move it. Am I talking with you? You never remember what God tell Nebuchadnezzar, humble yourself. Nebuchadnezzar what? Exalt himself. And instantly as he beat his chest, God. You see, God has went and lived down. Some of us have some high ass like when we go to Solomon and the road to Damascus. Some of us too high, too much pride, too much self. We feel with some pride that God needs to take some instruction class from us. We so pride that the Bible means nothing to us. We are so Jesus. Him said the church is in problem, they say, ask Jesus. Him said, listen, what I'm a leader, leave. They said, not my leader, because I have one leader, and that is Jesus Christ. He said, I don't mind how high position in the church. I said, his position was not as high as the position of Lucifer. Lucifer's position was higher. Lucifer was more brilliant. Lucifer had more authority. Lucifer had more command. And when Lucifer rebelled, God booted him out. Am I talking to you? Did it rain the church? Did it rain the church? Jesus said to Peter, you are Petra, a pebble. You are not stable. You are not rooted. But I am Jesus, the rock of ages and hope. And this rock, I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. The harder them come, the harder them fall. You can't fight against them and stand up. I said, Lucifer fall, but the church still won. And then many brilliant men would have left the church and said some things about the church, but the church still have gone. Now get caught up with who lead the church. Get caught up with who lead the church. Am I talking to you? Don't get caught up with who said this about the church. Get caught up with the law of the church. Because if you are built on Jesus Christ, you shall be victorious. Watch this now. After he prayed for the king and the king was restored, the king said, come on, come and bread with me now. They come and bread with me. There are times when some people want to punish you. Yeah, and I know them. Hello? Good sermon. Good sermon. We learn this is not just to listen to the word. Watch the face. Watch the expression. Good sermon. But they yell themselves, why they can't take you? Good sermon, but they don't know what is a coordinated conductor. He wiped out completely what was said before, and it set the tone for what is coming after. Good sermon, but you don't end up in legal against adultery. Good sermon, but you could have told out the thing about the dressing a little more because. You offend me. I don't be offended. And your dress offend you. Huh? Elijah was known to be the man who troubled Israel. Who was troubling Israel? Ahab and Jezebel. Huh? But the man of God said, God tell me not to eat bread and drink water from anybody. Matter of fact, he said, God tell me not even the direction I came in, I should go back in that direction. And he left. The Bible said, here comes a word prophet. And watch what the prophet said. The prophet never said, read it to each other. The prophet didn't say, God sent me. No. The prophet said, an angel tell me. What Paul said, even if an angel from heaven, and at least you know the direction that that angel is coming from. That angel is coming from heaven. But Paul said, even if an angel from heaven, come and preach anything to you which we're not with, don't believe it. And the man said, the first he resists, be careful of the charm. Be careful not to stay too long. Words have a way to weaken your resolve. Many young ladies would not get pregnant illegally if they've never stayed too long and listened to a general officer. In the 80s, the FBI warned the Navy that the Russian wants to use only trap to get them. And they said, be careful, because they're setting honey traps for you hard over. Now, the Navy is the most important member of the army. They guard any embassy. They are the first to touch down at 1,000 beaches. They were known as Lelelek. And their motto is simple fidelity, always faithful. and they knew what honey trap was. Anybody know what honey trap is? Okay. You want me to tell you? The Russians realized they could not match them with firepower. They could not match them with intelligence either. So the Russian was about to seek out the most beautiful prostitute in their nation and use them against them. And what Canadian guns could not do, women did it. The biggest scandal in the Navy is about women. The service men leave their boss with prostitute. But they didn't realize that they could work with Israel at this place. What's the name of the place again, Pastor? Where they start mingling with sex so much. You know the name of the place, Bridget? It is Bell what? Something like that. Today, the same thing is happening in Israel. It is happening among us. Our men cannot maintain their sanity. As soon as breeze blow and the fractal pass in the air, my God. Not only that, we are going outside and we are carrying in Egyptians. And we are marrying them. Not only the men, but the women. And we even decide that. Because she pleases you well. Same thing Samson said. I know you will be sad because if no charm in his handsome and his dog and it can't carry the head over, it can carry you everywhere, but it cannot carry you in the presence of God. Because only an Israelite can be a priest. And I want him who won't be a priest. Compromise. Sell out. The man of God went to have food with the false prophet. You know the Bible said he lied unto him. He lied unto him. And while he was feasting, God dropped a revelation in the false prophet mind. Tell the man, because of his disobedience, he shall not be buried in the place of his father's sepulchre. And the donkey stand up on the other side. The false prophet will find him and bury him. But I'm coming down. When you read 2 Kings 23, Josiah went on a mission. Am I not with you? I am there. 2 Kings 23. We're not going to be able to read the whole passage because of time. But that Josiah went on a mission. Josiah was a young king. And what's part of this mission? They were rebuilding the temple. And the book of the Lord had not been read in Israel for centuries. Was now discovered. For the first time, Matthew, the king realized the predicament that the land was in. When he read the word, he said, prophetess. Remember the prophetess told them? Tell the man who sent you. Because the humble said, he shall be saved. But not even his prayer will be able to stop the destruction that will come upon Israel. But because the humble said, he will not live to see the destruction. Many will not be able to stop the destruction that is coming upon Israel. But we don't have to be destroyed. Because provision has been made to save us. Am I God with you? And God never sent us to stop the destruction. God sent us to draw people out of the destruction. He wants to draw you out. And that's why I said, leave Babylon. but plan an emergency field trip for tomorrow. I have to get on a bus in JUTC fleet to carry me from this way. Call an emergency fish ride tonight, Elder Davis. You can catch all the fish in the ocean. Tomorrow you'll have no life. Everybody turn on the fish ride. Put on a social tomorrow. Tonight, call an emergency social. But may the Lord drop it in the spirit as a call an emergency fasting tomorrow. And so you turn up. I said to you, who have nothing to do but to fast and prayer. We're too busy, but we're not busy going to hell. We're too busy doing everything by turning my eating on our houses. We're too busy doing everything and we're losing our identity. We're losing our connection. We're losing our faith in Jesus. The king went on a mission. He teared down the altars. He mashed down the golden calves. He grinded them to powder. He beat up the bodies and the priests. And he burned the bone and the altar. He teared down the houses of the Sodomite. Somebody need to tear down something in that neighbor's church. Tear them down. Need to tear down the clique. Not in the church. Hello? Hello? We need to tear down gossiping from the church. We need to tear down fornication from the church. We need to tear down the false worship that we have in the altar. We need to tell some people straight, you don't dress right. So you can't go there. Oh, this is where I put myself in trouble now. This is where I'm going to invite the back on the other group. Better do this. But we need to tell some people, you just go short. You just go tight. Clean up your lip. Clean up your jaw. Clean up your nail and come. We need to tell some people, you can't serve this year because the money of a relationship with can't be your man because it's not what I mean by God. We need to tell some people, put your house in order. Put your house in order. We can't say people look like a lot of things are going to happen. A lot is happening. And that is happening. And it will take some of us by surprise. Because majority are we not ready. We're just not ready. We're not ready, church. We're not ready. We're getting ready. We're not ready. We have a form of godliness. But they might not scare us. God is going to move in Israel. God is going to move in Israel. And when God move, I want to move in God. God is going to do something in Israel. And when God does something in Israel, I want to be a part of it. I'm going to go with somebody. When this church is revived, I want to be revival. And it is not if it will be revived. It is going to be revived. Revival is taking place right now. You might not sit on the heart because something wrong with you. But God is reviving his people. Get ready, church. Get ready. I boast not of words, nor tell of good deeds, for
somebody, what next? Somebody, what next? Somebody, what next? Somebody, who's next? Hold on to that person. Hold on to that person. Hold on to the person. Ask the person to stand with you. Ask them to stand with you. Ask them to stand with you. Somebody, who's next? Ask them to stand with you. Ask them to stand. As you stand in with you, just ask them to walk with you. Just stand in with you. Just ask them to walk with you. Let's go. Just ask them to walk with you.
To God for a financial breakthrough. And for 10 days, we've been speaking to God about our health. Because many of us, even standing here, your health is giving you a beat. You are struggling financially. Spiritually, you are weak. Your family is at an all-time low. The condition in our communities are alarming. Today, as we make the final push today, you want to unite with me to the Lord for a breakthrough. Just leave your seat and come. You want to say to the Lord, do something special. You want to experience some supernatural healing. You want to hear the voice of God. Do you want to see the move of God? Church, you can't present your family. Come, stand in the gap for your community. Come, stand in the gap for a financial breakthrough. Come, and stand in the gap for your health. We assume that nobody should be left in this. The only person should still be in the seat is Jesus.
Many of us, we are our children here.
there would be nothing at our hearts to want to give your life to Jesus. And if the Lord speak to me, provision can be made. Consider your soul's salvation. Turn over to Jesus. Give him what is left of you, so that he can read you. Something like that. Listen, we have all of them. You finish your day. Turn him over to Jesus. The Holy Month is Sabbath, we are seven. We are talking to the Lord. Maybe you are, your heads are bowing, your heads are closed in the land. You're talking to Jesus. Gracious Father, we thank you. We thank you. We are not deserving your mercies, but we thank you. We're not deserving another chance. Would have done all to destroy ourselves. But Lord, we're thankful for the blood. We're thankful for the blood. Because of the blood, we have access to the throne of grace and glory. Because of the blood, we have deliverance. Because of the blood, we have freedom. Because of the blood, the chains that you have given us this day. Lord, you want us to make it right. We are struggling, but we have come. But Lord, we have been battered and bruised, but Jesus, we have come. We are weak, but Lord, we have come. Feeling this dust above ourselves, but Jesus, we have come. Sometimes the night seems too long, but Lord, we have come. We have come, Jesus. We have come. We are twisted, but we have come. We have come, Jesus. We have come. Oh Lord, we're hearing many different voices. We're seeing many different directions, but we have come. We have come. We have come to the source of our salvation. We have returned to the God of our Father. We have returned, Jesus, to Abraham's deliverer. We have returned. We have returned. We have returned. And it's not just of our bodies we have returned, but we are returning our minds. We are returning. Thank you that there is a voice in Jonah crying out against the altar. We are grateful that you are a prophet and you have sent words of instruction. Help us to heed them as we live in these explosive days of evil. And as we walk the tightrope of life, may we be wise enough to put our confidence in you. We pray for every visitor today, for every car, every name, every video, that they will recognize that time is what they don't have, so that they can make their call and an election short. May your spirit continue to speak. Let your spirit continue to lead. Let your spirit guide them. And keep case there's a eunuch in this place, Sennacherib. We thank you for these 10 days. We thank you for the intentions that you have put in us, the desires that the Spirit would have planted in us, for the sacrifice that would have been made. We thank you because we believe in the name of Jesus. Something has happened. Something will happen. Change in the heart. Deliverance will be experienced. And we are claiming it in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We are claiming the deliverance. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the people of God just lift their hands and say hallelujah. Just lift your hands and say praise the Lord. Somebody shout for Jesus.
Jesus.
Just shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
God bless you. As you return to your